That I appreciate that you managed getting onions from Egypt. I come from Maharashtra, which is the largest pool collector of onions. Why has the production gone down? But the onion prices, when they were rock bottom, is the time of duration you gave. Was that the reason that they did not get the rice, remunerative prices, the MSP was not good?
मैं इतना लहसुन प्याज नहीं खाती हूँ जी, so don't worry. मैं इतना लहसुन प्याज नहीं खाती हूँ जी, so don't worry. मैं ऐसे परिवार से आती हूँ जहाँ अनियन प्याज का मतलब नहीं रखते हैं. नो ऑनरेबल मेंबर सुप्रिया जी, आई मस्ट से फ्रॉम 2014 आई हैव आल्सो बीन पार्ट ऑफ सम ऑफ द ग्रुप ऑफ मिनिस्टर्स व्हिच मॉनिटर्ड द अप्स एंड डाउन्स इन अनियन मार्केट्स. समटाइम्स व्हेन देयर इज अ सरप्लस ऑफ क्रॉप वी हैव आल्सो फैसिलिटेटेड बाय गिविंग सपोर्ट टू those people who want to export it. I have overnight passed orders for helping with 5 to 7% assistance for exporting it. There are severe structural problems related to onions. One is we don't have scientifically advanced methods of storing, and I must appreciate the effort Nitin Gadkari ji, my senior colleague in the cabinet, has made. He even went to the extent of getting the Baba Atomic Research Center to come and tell how through radiation we can remove the moisture content of the onion and be preserved it for a longer shelf life. Like that, several Nitin Gadkari ji ka usme itna effort tha. 1 minute. So that is one of the things. So we need to have greater scientific storage facility for onions, and we have started working on it. And for
because you know, so I know your stand on research for GE is of the government.
Not every radiation, as much as I know, is harmful. Particularly for perishable food items, there are scientifically accepted level which doesn't harm the human element. All that is kept in mind. Then, also to give better storage capacities within that region, particularly. It's all right. Supriya ji is not my party, but still I hear her. Professor, don't worry. So, the storage capacity, the type of storage, and also around Lasalgaon. I think most of us have heard of Lasalgaon thanks to Nitin ji. Bar bar he has spoken to us about the pride that is in terms of onion capacities. So we are looking at ways in which we can improve the post-harvest capacities for onion. This year particularly, we've also had some of these districts' undue weather conditions, flooding. As a result, the acreage has come down. And therefore, I think we have to keep the context in mind and not, I mean, I would want to, matter of fact, all of us will have to look at the way in which onion, which is a very seasonal crop, which doesn't have a long shelf life, it is a perishable, truly perishable vegetable. So it's something on all of us will have to look at ways in which. So the last thing about IDBI, we have after the 4 hours about which I've repeatedly spoken, after the 4 hours, now improvement for onion.
तो जब ऑनियन की शॉर्टफॉल हो रहे थे तो पीएमटी मेजर की तहत तुरंत बाहर से क्यों नहीं आयात किया आपने? अगर ठीक तरीके से आयात करते थे तो इस हालत नहीं होते. और दूसरे बात, आप कुछ कहते हैं कि बिचौलिया आ गए, जमाखोर आ गए, तो वजह क्या है कि बिचौलिया के चलते, जमाखोर के चलते, ये आपकी सरकार की जो रवैया उसकी कमियां की चलते, सरकार की कामकाज की कोई कमियां की चलते, बिचौलिया की चलते, जमाखोरी की चलते, या सही वक्त पर आयात नहीं किया गया इसी के चलते, वजह क्या आप जानना चाहते हैं?
सर ओनियन इज नॉट द ओनली.
नो आई एम एड्रेसिंग ऑन एवरीथिंग ऑल्सो. प्रेमचंद्रन जी आई एम एड्रेसिंग एवरी इश्यू. आई एम ऑल्सो एड्रेसिंग द इश्यू रेज बाय वन ऑफ द ऑनरेबल मेंबर्स, एंड देयरफॉर you should have the patience to listen to that also. No, I will listen to you. All right. Onion is something which even Adarji raised. Maharashtra MP's race. So it's my duty to respond to them also. Hold on. So, hey, I'm coming to IDBA. So the 4 R's that we adopted about reorganizing, restructuring, and recognizing that there's an NPA problem gave us this recapitalization step. Recapitalization was done by government by infusing 21,157 crores into IDBI since 2015 after we came. And LIC infused 21,624 crores. So both put together have given 42,781 crores to the IDBI only because of the rampant loan largesse which happened during 8 and 14. Now, this has reduced the net NPAs, therefore the NPA ratio from the peak of 17.3% in September of 2018, it has come down to 5.97% now in September 2019. So from 17.3, it has come down to 5.97, which is below the RBI's 6% net NPA threshold. And therefore, under the prompt corrective action, IDBA has come out because of this infusion of cash done by the government and also by the RBI, by the LIC. Now, therefore, the supplementary demand for grant, if it comes in, it is only because we are constantly correcting those errors, those largesse, those benefits which were given between 2008 to 2014 as a national responsibility. So I hope that sort of addresses the majority of the questions. There were questions raised on railways, which I do not want to take too much time. I will probably stop with this. There is this question of the insurance companies. I have given you one on the IDBI. There are a few other things which I can go on an elaborate thing. I'm coming. That is something which you flagged today. I'm not giving it as an assurance, but that is something which I've heard from you. I'm certainly not giving an assurance, but I'll have to go back and see. You've given me some data, I'll have to go back to see. Where does that come from? Is it all NPA? What is it? I have to see. So let me go back to see that. As regards to the last word, sir, you say main sum up karungi. To maintain the regulatory minimum solvency across of the three public sector general insurance companies, United India Insurance, National Insurance, and Oriental India Insurance, this solvency is required, that which has been claimed here under the supplementary demand for grants. And therefore, I would want this infusion be cleared as a supplementary demand, because to write any new business, the pressure being faced by these companies on their balance sheets and margins will have to be eased out. And to bring in sustained growth and momentum to these companies, we need this infusion. And that is where the supplementary demand for grant includes 2,500. I've not finished. I've not even sat down, Mr. Kodikunil Sulesh. I've not even sat down. I have not even sat down. NPAs on Mudra, I've just been given something which I can share as a preliminary input. I'll of course have to come back. Against the total loans dispersed, Mudra ke upar, 2.52 is all that we have as NPAs. Against the total loans given under Mudra, 2.52% only is the NPA. Against the total amount outstanding, how much is outstanding? 6% is all that is outstanding. So outstanding is something beyond due time. But I've already given you the input. So with that, I suppose, स्पीकर सर, मुझे इतना समय आपने दिया उसके लिए मैं धन्यवाद कहना चाह रही हूँ. एलैबरेटली जवाब देने का मौका मिला मुझे. इसके बाद मैं आपके द्वारा रिक्वेस्ट करना चाहती हूं कि हाउस सप्लीमेंट्री डिमांड्स फॉर ग्रांट्स को पारित करें, जिससे सरकार चलाने में सुविधा होगा।